This is a little video of my Vestax Vci 400 case. Some of the stuff I did, mods I did. First of all, as you guys can see, this is an IEC adapter for the. I had to make a hole, and it's all messed up now. And it's bad, but it doesn't matter. I did this so I can get all the power cables and for it to be clean on the outside. I had my Pioneer DDJT1 case, which was bigger. It had a hole in the middle on the bottom, and I could actually run all the wires through there and through that table right there. That table right there actually did a circle. As you guys can see in my other videos, I made a circle in it so all the wires could go through the case. But this case doesn't have a hole, so what I did is I'm just gonna need two cables, the XLR cables and the power cable, which is thinner. And then since this case is smaller, it fits in my table better, so I can actually have more space to put more stuff in it. Show you guys. Let me see. Put this up, and then I'll show you guys what I did. I added an SMD 5050 LED strip. These are green, yellow, and red tri LEDs in one. This is I believe it's 3 feet, so it runs through the top and then through the bottom. And then on the bottom, let me see if you guys can see this thing. Kinda. Sorry about that. You guys can see it runs all along here through there, and this is what I did. Sorry if it moves, it's recording it with a phone. And this is for the LEDs to get it powered and all that stuff. This right here, that's the sensor for the LED wireless remote, which I believe is somewhere under. This is since I'm gonna have this, everything that's in this case, it's gonna stay here. I got like 3 chargers for my Mac. I got a new one at the box. I got this one, and I got another one that I use when I'm like all over. This is a USB cable for the VCI 400. This one has a blue LED, it lights up. And then I got this master cable RCA to, I believe it's 3/4 of them. I don't know. It's an aux cable. I can plug it into the headphone jack on my computer and then get sound from there through here. I wrapped all the cables, all those 3-4 cables here, so that way whenever it moves, you can see, stretches as far as this right here. As you guys can see, moves, advances back, and when it's time to pack, this the case covers everything. All this covers it. And there's another brick here for the light case for it not to move. I got all my stuff here. As you guys can see, this is the IEC cable, sorry about that. I run it over here. I got this outlet with three outlets. This is for the VCI 400 power brick. This is for the Mac charger, and this is for the LEDs. This is the USB I was telling you, the power cable, the aux cable, which is connected to the line. And then I got these quarter inch to RCA. This is not a balanced output, I could actually plug in the RCA's, because these are unbalanced. I've got two, or I could use them as a mic. The XLR cables, what else? On this case, I left these phones. This helps the VCI not to move when it's
when I DJ somewhere else, hack it for mobile use. So I left those on the other DDJ T1. I didn't do that. I wasn't thinking about that, about the protection and stuff. On this one, I actually did. So I worked my way around these things. That's why I kind of, as you guys can see, it's like, these are already with 3M tape, and I had to do like all this bunch of stuff here. Sorry, this is duct tape. I had to do all this bunch of mods for it to work. As you guys can see, it looks neat. If this hole was bigger, I could actually run the wires through here, the XLR cable, and some of the other wires I might need. But I mean, it works for me. And as you guys can see, front. Oh, this is the cable I was telling you guys about. The IEC through, and then this is right angle, which is better. It doesn't stick up that much, it just goes through like this. And then on the bottom, I made like a laptop dock, so I could actually leave my laptop with a case in it, and then it doesn't move. It reaches all the way through here, and as you guys can see, those rubber feet, 1, 2, 3, help the laptop not to move. And as you guys can see, that's my Mac case. And then I got a friend that's gonna hook me up with the virtual DJ registration thing, so I can get the full version, the pro version. So what I did is just lay out the decals for virtual DJ, as you guys can see. And I kind of added some of those stickers, an Apple sticker here, got one of those little stickers here, another sticker here, little dots here, little dots here, another sticker here. And what else did I do? Basically that's it. So just the LEDs light up. They're not sound active, so I mean that's the only thing that sucks. But I mean at least they light up. I'm gonna show you guys how it looks when it's hooked up and everything. In just a few minutes. And I'll let you guys. Show you guys how my setup looks. I got the video running HDMI, high definition, got 720p, and I got them running from my MIDI display port from the Mac. This is how it looks with the LED, the on cable, the Mac charger, and then this camera. And I'm running this with these things, the limited edition. One of my homies gonna hook me up. Installing the pro version. He paid for it, so he's gonna hook me up. SD Raw. Shout out to that homie. Son Latino. And DDJ Pollo 89. Those are down for mixing videos. I mean, down. So, this is their setup.
So you guys, what's up? Pioneer, so. All right. Thanks, guys.